So, here we have Google Earth coming in, and I'm going to show you how we can sell land, vacant land, or a house on a lot of land, and show how the land is contoured. And when that land is contoured, how you can landscape on that, and how it would look landscaped. And you can show a pre-existing structure. In this case, I'm going to John's house, and I've got to Google Earth, and this is a flat photo of his. But now, on that flat photo, I've constructed some animation on top. It's like an augmented reality, and that's on top of the flat two-dimensional surface. That gives me things to scale, but remember, the Earth is not contoured. Then I have a function to actually take the contoured mountain on which John lives, and I went from 0 to 400 feet and I contoured at 25 foot intervals. So that's really cool, because now you can see the scale of things. Look at it. As I zoom in, you're going to see the cars. You can see the cars look quite small on the highway, and you can see each one of those contours is a 50 foot increase going up until we land on. And now I have to adjust the position of each house to fit the land, to conform to the land. So I manipulate them a little angle here and there so that they're on the ground flat but angled towards the landscape as it's angled there. Then I put in these trees, and you can see I add some maguey bushes in there. So you know, now to give you an idea, it's just something I threw in to show you how you can landscape once you've contoured. And so that's what I did there. You can see that now I'm going to take a look at the whole setup, and now I'll remove the contour lines from the things. Look at the land as it would look without the contour maps. Behind, you can see I'm going up to the highest point of the section. Now I can take a lot bigger map section, map out a huge mountainside if you want to use that to sell pieces of land and show how a house would sit on that land and say look over the ocean or whatever. So this right here, that's pretty cool. If you notice, that's what it looks underneath. And this is the same map previously, but now I removed the contours and left the structures and the trees and the landscaping on this unobstructed view, you see. So that makes it very nice. Kind of bobbling around a little bit to get in there close, but you get the idea. I'm going back in to show the whole setup. Now I would go with my virtual reality camera next time I see John's place, and I'll put it on the outside to do a 360 scan. And you know, if I were selling the house, I would do an inside scan of the home, which is brilliant really, to help sell both the land, the home, and the landscaping that you might want to add. This house, notice the car is a little bit high, it's off the ground. So I'm going to go in and just adjust it to show kind of how I would do that. I downloaded that model, that car, from somewhere else. That's John's hot rod. And I have to have the tires touching the earth, you'll see. See, just touch the earth, because it was a little bit in the air, and so that, and that's just showing off. And now I'll pan out and I'll show you the what I did now was do the reverse and put complete contours and took away the land. So here you can see now, it's kind of cool. I left the houses on there so you can see kind of what this thing looks like if you were just looking at the contour map itself, but in a three-dimensional. You know, most contour maps are on a flat and you have to figure out the altitude by reading the number. But this is pretty cool. You see, and back there, there's the highest part of the map, the very tip behind the house. And there you go, it shows you how you can use this to market using this virtual reality system and the 3D animation. And so I'm going back in, take one good look at that Mustang, because it's pretty cool. I want to see the kind of detail they have inside of that car. And you can see it's pretty cool for sketching it up. I left it there. So when you get in closer and closer, it's a little harder to keep the fidelity of the knob so that you can scan right into it. But you can see there's steering wheel and seats and such. And the back window is pretty cool. Anyway, Now you'll see all four settings, a 2D,